Hi there, Michael from the Red Chair Diaries, Bedford, Nova Scotia. I wanted to talk about something, the first kiss, or the first same gender kiss. I was so captivated by Eric's video where he was talking about his first kiss with a German, and I think it was actually his first, you know, gay kiss, same sex kiss, same gender kiss. And it does bring back memories. I did have this down as a topic. I prepared a list of topics of things that I wanted to get to at some point, since this is, you know, a diary from my house, and by definition, it's mostly about me, isn't it? Whether anybody's interested or not. And I can still remember it was April 1974, over 36 years ago, and a gay friend who was spending some time in my apartment, I think he had just come back from Manitoba or someplace like that. Anyway, the actual circumstances is not so clear, but the person who I'm not going to name on the net, it was there that evening. There's a few guys in, and I wasn't out yet, you know, but I guess the cracks were starting to show. Pardon me. And we went to the kitchen, because I mean, I was quite captivated by this fellow, and we were in the little galley kitchen that we had in my apartment, and you know, he was a very sexy fellow, and he just stood there. And all, you know, he just slouches with his hand on his hip, basically, sort of thing, like it's one of his habits. And he took me, took my my face into, my face, you know, my chin or whatever, into his hands, and bent close, and that was it. And I responded, and it was absolutely electrifying, just like Eric said. Or maybe I should be talking to Eric right now. And I've never forgotten it. And I had done a lot of kissing in my time, because I had a girlfriend in grade 9. And as many of us did, you know, trying to tell myself I was feeling something and I wasn't. And in university, I had a girlfriend the last year. We slept together, but I never did get to sex. And there was a lot of necking and kissing. And before that, there was another girl. And we're talking some good-looking girls, okay? And I remember being at a party or something with one of them. That was my date, and we were going to it, standing up somewhere and necking and all that sort of stuff, you know, because I was like 20 or 21, I guess, and I thought, well, this is what you're supposed to do, right? And I remember that, and I remember, oh yes, okay, the movies I've seen and the books I read, I guess I'm supposed to feel her breast or something like this, and I remember trying to do that, and I was just mortified. It was just not, as they say, just not on, just not working for me. As I was, you know, sticking my tongue down her throat and all that sort of stuff, and just thinking about it makes me really embarrassed and mortified, you know? That's when I was presumably gay, and then, of course, a year or two later, or maybe a couple of years later, I guess, I graduated in 73 from university, so following year, you know, that one event, just this feels different. I really, yeah, this is good, you know. And before the next 2 weeks was, well, first I slept with this fellow like the next night and the night after. Before the 2 weeks were out, then I had another one. You know, I really started my gay life off in a very, very sordid way, because I basically stole the boyfriend or the fellow that my house guest was interested in, who he introduced me to, and then this fellow and I started and went on, had an affair over the summer. So, you know, I didn't say I was honorable, but it takes two, doesn't it? And each event, of course, cascades or builds, I should probably say, until it becomes a lifestyle, if you want to use that word, but or a life, actually. It gave me a life. But I just want to say, you know, Eric, I don't envy you, because you're young and, you know, you're going to have some fun. And I was there, I had it, and it's great. And just try to get that picture, try to get that head picture, mind picture, third eye picture, mind's eye picture, whatever you want to call it, you know. And you're never going to forget it. You know, and as I said in my note on YouTube, you know, it'll come back to you when you're cold and you're lonely. It's something that has a value. Don't discount it. Don't overbuild it, but at the same time, it is important. It's like where females talk so often, or at least in the past they used to, about they're going to save themselves for marriage because they build something up. Well, with us, I guess, we gay guys, it's probably, things quite often are more happenstance, you know, like you don't have that defined time. And most gay guys are not trying to hold themselves off for marriage, nor hold themselves off for the right one, because that is a minefield of disappointment and depression. You do have to play the field. I mean, if you're one of the lucky ones who meet one guy and never ever go out with another guy for the next 50 years, I'm not so sure if I should salute you or feel bad for you. You know, sow some wild oats, but it's always important. That first kiss possibly may be more important or more monumental in your mind than the first sexual act that you actually have with somebody else, or another guy, I should say. Because I cannot actually remember too much about the sex, but I remember the kiss that was in isolation, you know, the previous night or whatever it was. Anyway, fantastic. I'd love to hear other people's videos about their first kiss, because kissing is the communication that we have when we're intimate. It's not always talking, is it? It's not always feeling one's legs or whatever, you know, and some stroking a shoulder. But kissing is it, when at least when you're in the throes of passion, I think. Okay, anyway, sorry to bore you. This old man here looks like Rod Steiger now with my short hair, trying to get my scalp condition in check. Anyway, I hope everybody sees me around and at the Red Chair Diaries, and maybe you'll even subscribe, and only if you like it. If you don't like it, I don't care about your subscriptions. Okay, bye-bye. Take care.